All right. Howdy, 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 folks. I am glad to be here. And this will be short. Okay. I got a question that said, hey, my cart's here. Everything's ready, but I got approval for my chili. But do I go with a canned chili or do I go with homemade chili? I've got a cooler recipe. Well, that's true. A lot of us have somebody in our family that's got a recipe for something, right? And that's okay. That's okay to want to share your recipe or use your recipe in hopes that it will pull more people or make them faithful to your brand, because where else can you get Mama Johnson's chili if not from my hot dog cart? So here's the thing. There's several parts to this, but I'll run through it quickly for you. The first is that when you're first starting out, you are adding headaches. You are adding a pain in the neck. Another thing you have to do, you have to now buy chili ingredients, make chili, package chili in a safe way so that you can re-thermalize, which means heat up. The FDA and, you know, ANSI standards call it re-thermalize, but you'll take it to the cart and heat it back up and serve it. Problem is, even if your chili is the bomb, there's about a blue million people that will say that their chili's the bomb. And now there's chili cook-offs and stuff, and there's actually a world record chili federation. And I think the winner for the last few years has been the same brand, Chili Man's. It's in my book, you know, my course book, because I used it, because it was the only one I could find that had a vegetarian chili, and I was required to use a vegetarian chili. I'm not going to go into that story right now, but the bottom line is that is why I found Chili Man's. Well, Chili Man's tastes good, but it's not like the best chili to me in the world or anything. And I don't know if there is a best. I could eat six bowls of good chili and be tickle pink with all six of them. So in the beginning, use canned chili. Okay. Make life easy on you. Now, let's say you want to set yourself apart with chili. Like I was talking about the other day, there's vendors that use mustard. They use mustard as their come on or their, and then some of them use hot sauce. They'll have 16 different types of hot sauce you can put on your hot dog or your sausage or your broad or whatever. So, hey, Dragon Wieners, here's what you're faced with there is, one, you just want consistency in the beginning and you want to make your life easier, because honestly, having that Mamaw's chili recipe on your card in the beginning is not as crucial as you being consistent with whatever you decide, and you're not creating new labor problems, new things that you have to do to make your cart run consistently the same. And if it's a matter of going to the grocery store and buying some Castleberry's chili, okay, or going to Sam's Club and getting some chili, you can go do that stuff and you will come out ahead. And you can results. Hold on just a second. That stupid phone. Okay, so it heard me say chili and it said, here's your top search results for chili. So anyway, that's just one thing. There's vendors that have made their own cheese sauce. There's vendors that make their own sauerkraut. There's vendors that make their own, like the Coke onions. You really can't buy that. Bacon jam. There's things like that. But unless that's important to you to have your very own private labeled, as far as it's Mamaw's chili or John, you know, Papaw's chili recipe, nobody's got this. I had to beg for this on her deathbed to get it, kind of thing. Unless it's that important to you, don't do it. Now, let me tell you a little secret. You can buy Castleberry's, you can buy any brand you want and jack it up a notch. Just be consistent with your jacking it up. Okay. And a lot of people will ask, okay, well, what type of chili? What should I go with, a bean chili or no bean chili? And you come to the Carolinas and the Carolinas, a lot of times they use a no bean and it's very fine grated up. It's like a chili sauce. It's kind of ground up beef, but it's so ground up fine. The chili sauce is drier as far as it's a thicker sauce, because it's mostly just ketchup and meat. So, but there's some good ones. You can, depending on what your area likes, like my wife likes chili with beans in it, big old beans, even on her hot dog. Me, I prefer it without the beans. I don't need that. But I don't care either way. I'll eat it either way. You can take those products, though, and jack them up. You can add a little garlic, a little cumin, a little paprika, a little cayenne. If you're handy with stuff like that, make it your own. Let's say your chili is just bland. It's not real tasty, and you want to jack it up a notch. There's cool things you can do. You can add mango juice to it and create a little tang to it and a little bit of cayenne or red pepper. And you can do those little things without making it so hot that you have to warn people. You can make it your own. You can do the same thing with cheese sauce. You can do the same thing with slaw. You can do the same thing with sauerkraut. There's a blue million things. We talked about dirty water dogs the other day. And dirty water dogs, you're kind of making a dog your own, because you're going to add flavors to it because you've created ingredients in the water. So that's how that helps and how that works for a lot of vendors is they think, oh, I gotta get the gourmet this, and I gotta have the chili. I gotta make my own chili. I got vendors that are making their own chili. It, to me, waste of time. Okay. Because I'll put money on, you give me anybody's chili, I'll take a bite, and it may be the best dang chili. I bet I can take about any can off the shelf and make it turn into that with just some seasoning additions. Okay. I don't care if they slow roasted in the Italian sun in the summer, their garlic, whatever they did, I can probably duplicate the flavor. So why go to the trouble? Why make your life? Now, as you get bigger and better, add other things. But to me, it's a waste of time even to do chili. Add things that maybe create as much work later, like coke onions. And you can get that recipe at learnhotdogs.com. Just type in coke onions or coke. Or bacon jam, like jam you put on butter, but bacon. You can't go wrong there, right? So that is what Amanda just said. Dragon wieners. I use Hormel, no bean, add spices, and pre-cooked ground beef. See, she's made Hormel her own. That ain't Hormel anymore. That's my chili. That's Dragon Wiener's chili. That ain't Hormel chili or Van Camp's chili or Bush's chili. Bush's is another good one. It's delicious chili. Ain't a record breaker. Nobody cares. Coke onions, Jamie, is you basically are cooking down onions to caramelize, okay? But you're caramelizing them in sugar. But the sugar we use is either Dr. Pepper or Coke. And so as they cook down in an iron skillet, you keep adding Coke. I've got a video. It's free. Watch it. It's here on YouTube. It's also on learnhotdogs.com. It's probably easier to find on learnhotdogs.com. Click in the search box, Coke onions. I did a video and the ingredients that I used to make it. It's phenomenal. And we have vendors that actually, people come up and buy just the Coke onions. I want a quart of Coke onions. And so it will become popular. That's a smarter use of your time and your efforts and will make you more money. Now you've set yourself apart. You didn't just go make a chili that's really dang good. There's a lot of chilies that are really dang good. Okay. So don't try to set yourself apart with something that's easily duplicated. Coke onions are trouble, but they're good. Okay. Bacon jam, trouble, but good. Okay. So check that stuff out and remember that, especially if you're just getting started. If you've already been in the business a little while, start testing one thing at a time. Bring in Coke onions or bacon jam, or maybe you want to try a new fresh brat, or maybe you want to start getting to your location an hour earlier, 2 hours earlier, and adding breakfast brats. You ever heard of them? Breakfast sausages. I'm talking morning type thick sausages or brats that are spiced with maple bacon, okay? You can do that. We had a vendor accidentally stumble into that business because he showed up early. Somebody said, hey, do you have breakfast? He said, no. They went ahead and waited around for hot dogs, but the bottom line is he changed over, and now he just does breakfast. We've had him on the show before. He put up AirPods, which squirt out the hot coffee, okay? And he's got like three different types of coffee or two different types of coffee, and then he's got breakfast brats, and he only works breakfast. Who's seen a hot dog vendor working just breakfast? he's figured it out. He figured that out. I hadn't done that. I've served breakfast from my cart, but I never like changed a location to a breakfast location. He was in a great spot to do that. Rodney says, called the health department. I have that process underway. They said that I don't need a business permit if I have my spot at the flea market outside of Pittsburgh. That is true, because the typically a flea market has an umbrella permit, which covers its vendors indoors, because some vendors indoors may just come for that weekend. That's the last time they're going to be there. The t-shirt guy, he's there every weekend. But the guy that comes, he goes, man, I got to sell Mamaw's estate, and takes all her stuff and puts it out there and sells it on a weekend, he doesn't need to go get a business license. So they give a permit to the flea market. I love flea markets, by the way. Go almost every weekend. Almost every weekend I go to an auction or a flea market. I freaking love auctions. Not furniture like auctions. I like chicken and pig auctions. Anyway, congratulations, Rodney. That's good news. Let's see. I have when I drove my truck. I don't know what you mean, Amanda. You have when you drove your truck. Anyway, there's so many different things you can do to make money and to do it smart in your business, to expand your business. Just know in the beginning, start slow. Okay, start slow. Oh, Dragon Wieners, breakfast cart. Breakfast carts are brilliant. Some people, you know, had that vendor who I taught how to vend, had he not come along with that story, I wouldn't have known, I don't think. He taught me that. He taught a bunch of us that. And so we have vendors now doing breakfast spots. Great income. I did breakfast at the flea market, okay? But I never considered doing breakfast at one of my normal locations. But I used to go to the flea market, and one day I kind of stumbled into the breakfast deal. They said, hey, you should come early and serve breakfast, because the flea market had a restaurant. They ain't open, you know? And I think it was Saturdays or Sundays they didn't open. I think it was Sundays. They didn't open the restaurant, okay, for breakfast. And so they'd open it for lunch, but not for breakfast. And somebody, one of the vendors asked, and I said, that's a good idea. I just brought out, I went and bought prepackaged biscuits. I'm not talking about from Sam's. I'm talking about, I went to a local, it's a grill called Chambers. And I'd buy like, you know, 300 biscuits with sausage in them. Biscuits and sausage gravy. I've done that on my big dog cart, DL. It is freaking delicious. Especially if you got a good gravy recipe. But my mom and dad had a little barbecue place, and they decided to start doing breakfast, and they did biscuits and gravy. And my mom was trying to make that much gravy for all those people, and it wasn't working. And so finally she went to, I believe it was Sam's. It may have been Costco. I don't know. I think it was Sam's, number 10 can of gravy. And it's called, you know, biscuit gravy, sausage gravy. And it's got a little bit of sausage in it. It's mostly just grease, right? White colored grease, off white. And she'd jack it up. She'd take a pound of sausage, grind it up, add a little olive oil to it, add some seasonings. Okay. You can add a little sage, you can add a little honey, or any kind of sweetener, cane sugar, molasses, just a little bit, stir it up. Okay. And make you like a short roux out of butter with the sausage and the grease, make you a short roux, a loose roux, add a little milk, and then dump it into your gravy. Now you've just created your own gravy from theirs without having to make 8 billion tons of gravy. Let's see. Menu for steak. Can I put slaw on the list? Yay or nay? Jim, you are in. Hold on. I know where you are. Hold on. You're going to Florida, I believe. You know what? It's 6 of one, half a dozen the other. Does code say no? The codes say no, okay, on slaw, unless individually containered, okay? But I have a vendor that I filmed there down in the middle of Florida. Where's that place where all those older people live? It's like a retirement village near Orlando. I went and filmed a lady there who put her daughter through college from one of our carts, and she was able to serve. She was serving Philly cheesesteaks on a pro dog. Okay. And they were letting her. So you, it depends on, you might get somebody good. Not Zephyr Hills. It's not Palm Beach. This is somebody that knows Florida, knows this area. It is like the largest retirement community in the Southeast United States. The whole town is retirement. It's not Kissimmee. Dadgum. Watch this. Let me see if I can get this answer while I'm here. I told y'all this was going to be short, but y'all know me better than that. Hey, what's that retirement village north of you that, you know, all the retired people go and live in Florida? I just asked my sister. She lives down there. She used to be a vendor. So there's a lot of, hey, thank you, DJ. I appreciate that. I know some of it, to some of you, you're going, duh. And some of you go, man, that's good information. And I get it. I can't always fit everybody, but I try to take questions that I get and I go, oh, I got a minute. I'll go online and tell them about that. I turned what could be, I'm probably one of the few people that can take a 30 second conversation and turn it into a 30 minute one for you. The villages. Booyah, Jim, you got it. That's it. The villages. That's a whole community. I mean, they got their own hospital. They got doctor's office. Knee replacement centers are more so than they have gas stations. It is huge. I filmed that lady down there and she was killing it. Her daughter had already graduated college at this point when I filmed her, and she was killing it with it. She was serving everything. Hello from Tampa, Joe Laurent, Tampa Sunshine Hot Dogs and Catering. Love it. Sunshine Hot Dogs and Catering. Love the name. Let me make sure I didn't miss anybody here. There's stuff that rolls by in front of me. I wouldn't put slaw on your list till you talk to the inspector. And you can always oops it, you know. Oh, we didn't even think about slaw. Oh, we can't do slaw. Can we do it in the containers? Oh, yeah, you can do it in the individual, you know, portion cups. Do I do that with the Department of State? Do I do what? Oh, registering. What do you think the next step would be as far as registering the business, enabling myself to operate elsewhere? The league. Oh, you would want to go ahead and do the normal steps for a vendor if you're going to operate outside the flea market. But the nice part is you can start in the flea market like Chef Jose did. Y'all seen him. I've put 3 videos up here of him. He started with a crock pot at a flea market in Florida. Okay. If, in fact, he's the guy that won the Cater Pro this year, or last year. It was for last year, but we give it away in January. He started with a crock pot. So, and we filmed him. So, and he's got his testimonials and everything on there. You can start with little to no money. Now, what I would do to answer your question, Rodney, is I would go ahead and start the process, but go ahead and start vending. Go ahead and start doing that and let that help pay for whatever license and fees to the state you're going to need. That was my concern. Talked to the owner of the flea market. And she said, it's a good start. Just wondering what I need to do to legalize myself to get out of there. That's simple. Let me give you directly to it, Rodney. Go to learnhotdogs.com. Okay. It's free. This is free. You don't buy nothing. Right at the top, how to start. It'll give you the steps. And I even have a video on there that shows actual in Florida. Like I was online in Florida. And when I did my demo, I picked several states and Florida was one of them. So you can check that out. Jim, you're welcome, brother. I'm happy for Jim. Jim's fixing to have a cart. Let's see. Anyway, that's it. That's all I got. I love you. I'll see you later tomorrow. I'm going auctioning and having fun and doing crazy stuff. So with my wife, she's got me going thrifting. I'm going thrifting tomorrow. She loves thrifting. That's her release. You know, some people drink bourbon, not saying names. Some people drink bourbon. She does thrifting. I'm going thrifting with her. So y'all have a freaking awesome day tomorrow. If you need me, still message me and I'll try to answer you. Oh, shit. Before I leave, breakfast tacos, a brilliant one. You know, we have those guys that have been on the show that are in Ohio doing breakfast stuff before they go to school. They are in college and they go to school, but we had them on the show. They got a Cater Pro, I think. And they're grilling pancakes and stuff for college students before school starts, before their classes start. And that's their whole deal. That's what they do. When the weather's permitting for them. Somebody had asked some stuff here. Let's see. Does Portland, Oregon have any good spots for a hot dog cart? This came from Leo Mickey, 62 McAllister. Portland, Oregon does have good spots for a hot dog cart. Same location stuff applies, but if you're on state property or city property, they have in Portland what's called food pods, where they say, here's an area where you're allowed to vend, and you'll find other vendors there. Okay. They're called food pods. Portland was smart by creating areas for vendors on public grounds. Private grounds, whole different deal. Go through, I mean, you name it, pick it. Again, Leo Mickey, go to learnhotdogs.com, type in locations in the search box. It'll give you so many, you'll probably blow a retina. I've given so many location ideas that other people don't think of. You know, when you first think about it, you're thinking 5th and Main. You know, I want to be at 5th and Main. No, there's plenty of locations that other people don't think about. I think that was it. Kevin B's helping his brother start a card. He posted on YouTube a message. Enjoy being go thrifting, drinking a crown here because my card is in production. I'm going to be drinking bourbon in a little bit. I have a meeting at 7:30 and that runs to about 8:30. And then I'm heading my butt home. And y'all, I got a new office. I'll be out of this. I'm in a real estate company's building right now when we moved. And so I rented an office from them. And that's why it never got set up with all my stuff. I'll be moving next week. And I'll show you around that little, it's not like there's much to show you. It's like an 8x10 and I'm going to show you the office. But hillbillies, like we get excited. We got a new pad. Y'all have a good one. Yeah. Dragon Wiener's got a cart being built right now too, a big dog. Freaking awesome. Love you. Talk to you later. Bye.